Welcome to another episode of Speaking Scientifically. Today's word is offspring. Offspring are the descendants or the young of a living thing. Dogs have puppies.
Oh, look at the cute little puppy.
Cats have kittens.
Ah, look at the cute little kitten.
Ladybugs have larvae.
Oh, look at the cute little larvae.
And plants have seedlings.
Look at those cute little seedlings.
The great thing about the word offspring is it replaces all of those and keeps things simple. And even when that puppy grows up,
look at the cute little puppy,
it's still going to be its parents' offspring. Now, each organism grows up according to a sort of blueprint or plan inside that it inherits from its parents. It's going to look a lot like its parents, but it's also going to be different in some ways. And some of those differences can be really important in helping it survive in certain situations in the future. When and how an organism has offspring is an important step in its life cycle. And it's one of the key things that we think about when we determine whether or not something is a living thing or a non-living thing. Does a pebble marry another pebble and have baby pebbles? No. Does a pond marry another pond and have pondlings? No, that's ridiculous. Ponds are non-living things. They don't have offspring. So if you're trying to figure out if something's a living thing or a non-living thing, ask yourself, does it produce offspring? If so, yes, it's a living thing. All right, I think you know now what the word offspring means. If there's more words you want to know, send them to me in a comment, and I might do your word next on Speaking Scientifically. Scientifically. Speaking scientifically.